Was pretty good today. I think the scoreline was a true reflection of the game and totality. We were quite patched up as well. We've got a youth within the group. Not a lot of luck went our way either. It's a cool game sometimes when we just lost the momentum shifts at important times. You know, the Lions are very good at in the last 30 metres of the field, you know, they're more still very good and a huge weapon for them. But they did get exposed quite a bit, you know, around the middle and on the edges. I just thought in the second half we were inaccurate in an attack. We tended to overplay the ball individually rather than serving teammates that are in better positions. It's a discipline that's sort of slightly we've lost recently, so it's something we'll need to get back if we want to continue to grow up in the area.
John Warwick in 12 did pretty good, and Travis coming back also had a good game as well.
Yeah, no, that's it was quite good to experiment with Warwick in 12. I know he's played a little bit of Super Sport Challenge there. Certainly has the ability to break up a side and get out of a tackle as well. Defensively reads really well, so there's potential future there for him as well. But it's always good to have Travis back. He's a solid individual and really good for the young guys.
Given what happened in Durban Lions 2 weeks ago, did you feel after three quarters here that you did it in a similar way?
I just thought, we thought that ultimately, end of the day, if we could be extraordinary in an attack, we just had to score more. We knew that we were going to probably concede, considering that the Lions, do have an average, four plus sort of per game. So I thought we defended for long periods of time extremely well. Certainly our rush defence put them under a lot of pressure and fed our attack. We just didn't, whenever there were crumbs or turnovers, the referee seemed to blow us up quickly, whereas they were allowed to play it out. So something I'll take up with the referee.
John, that's not the first time that's happened this season, it's the same referee.
Yeah, I might just reserve my judgment to the protocol and the process. Yeah, can't say that he's an outstanding form.
John, from what you've seen in the competition and so on, and having played all the teams and all the teams, I mean, what are the largest chances this year?
Yeah, I mean, clearly if you get a home final, you've got a big chance. But there's still plenty to play out. Still have to probably go to Christchurch to win this one.
John, not the ideal season for you guys. I mean, I think there's a lot of youth, obviously, in the side. What are some of the positives you can take out of this season?
Yeah, we're right in contention in this competition right up until second round of Sharks. One thing we haven't been able to control is the number of game impact injuries. We lost a lot of injuries, and then two props with 10 weeks of suspensions, critical losses. One thing it costs us is basically game injuries and a lack of depth adapting to Super Rugby level.
John, Tim Bellani and Marco, both of them were outstanding tonight. Both of them really played their hearts out as well.
Yeah, I mean, their energy was good. Marco got player of the day today. Got him off because obviously he's got he's a bit into the squad with the Springboks. He missed out last time because of potential ACL and ankle injury. So it's pleasing that he's got them through. His perseverance is unbelievable. And Bolly's had a good season. Still technically a couple of things that need to change in his game. Certainly in the way that he carries the ball, he sort of loses a little bit too much ball for this level, so he'll need to correct that. And that's something that, that we can change. It's something that got better during the season. It's just come back again, so we'll need to address it.
Mitch, from what you've seen, do you think there's any side that can stop the Crusaders?
If you look at the two teams in the competition that have the ability to go to their scrum and go to their maul, then the Crusaders and the Lions are the two teams that. You don't have to go and play a whole lot of flash rugby. And perhaps the Crusaders are slightly better defensively. If you look at the last two competitions that have been won by Lions teams in defence, so that probably gives you some indication of what's coming in the final series. But yeah. Yeah, the Lions and the Crusaders are the best in terms of what at scrum and they can dictate performance through that sometimes.
Given how the competition started for you and how it panned out eventually, with what mindset are you into next season? Do you feel that you have to sort of backtrack a little bit before you move forward?
No, we've got a very good process. We've got very good systems. We're going to have to recruit. Yeah, as simple as that. So we've got to change our model from quantity to quality. And create two teams of Super Rugby quality to be able to handle and manage loads and injuries and stop exposing youngsters too quickly in this competition and relying on youngsters. You can't handle this competition relying on a smearing of test players and expect them to be able to last a full season.
Thank you.
Thank you.